have to say, through the whole month of drier January, I have made a conscious effort to be drier, and it really has made me think that it's made me really look at how I drink, and I want to always keep myself within this not lower risk every week, whereas normally you could slip into it and think, oh, I'll have an extra one or I'll do that. Last week I haven't actually done too badly. The only problem was that all my units consumed were all in the one night. So that wasn't great, but I've not touched a drop since. Whereas normally I'd have thought I was going to go out Saturday and I thought, do you know what? I've had enough. And it actually made me realise, and it's something, I'll hang on to this and it'll make me realise and it'll really make me think. So the advantages for me of Dry January have been that it's made me look at exactly what I'm drinking and whether I actually need it or not.
Do you know, the habitual bevvies at the weekend were hard to avoid. I'm going to be perfectly honest. During the week, it's just a piece of cake. It really is a piece of cake. However, with monitoring how much that I have been consuming and sort of holding back, I am feeling a lot better, and I'm going to continue this, as you know, throughout February and for the best part of March, right up until the 22nd of March. Now, from the 22nd of February to the 22nd of March, I won't be having a drink at all. That's why I've allowed myself a couple of bevvies at the weekend, but I've been conscious of how much I've been drinking, and I've certainly been drinking a lot less than I normally would.
Do you know what? I feel so much better. I've actually lost weight, which is something I've not even tried to do. I've lost about 3 or 4 pounds, and that just makes you realise you don't feel as sluggish. You wake up the next morning, like, to wake up on... didn't feel great waking up Saturday morning, I will say that, but to wake up on Sunday morning, I was awake at like 8:30 and ready to go, and I just felt so much better. I've got loads more energy.
As I said, the Monday to Friday bit is fairly easy. In fact, it's one of those, it's discipline, it's what I do. I'm up at 4 o'clock in the morning, so I can't be getting up feeling fuzzy headed first thing in the morning but to host a breakfast show. So that was the easy bit. It was Friday, when you've got a couple of days off, Saturday, especially after the football, I love nothing better than going to the Joe Mercer Suite at Goodison and having a couple of pints and recapping in the match and having the banter with the guys. So they're the habitual pints that, you know, that you sort of miss a little bit.
I think what I've learned throughout Dry January, I will keep on with me for a long time. And like I say, I will keep holding my diary to keep an idea. I know what bracket I want to be in now, and I do kind of think, right, well, I don't want to push it, I don't want to get into that middle bracket, I want to stay in the lower risk. And it really has made me think what I drink, and it's definitely something I'll continue through the year.
Well, I've really upped my training for that, and I think the fact that I've really not been drinking as much and really, really been, you know, keeping an eye on my intake, that's help make the training easier. So with that, that's something to focus on as well. So I'm feeling a lot better. Yeah, I'm feeling a lot better.
And over the next couple of months before your charity boxing event, are you going to try and keep in training and keep healthy?
I'm going to have to keep in training, otherwise I'm going to look pretty silly getting into that boxing ring. You know, I need to be in shape. I need to work on my footwork, I've been told. And as I said, with that, it goes hand in hand. Stay off the booze, train hard, and you'll feel better, and I'll probably look better on the night.